What's happening, people? Back with another reaction, back with some more soundtrack slash score. That is to say, we're going to listen to a piece of music from the 1994 film Interview with the Vampire. Now, if you know the film, you'll know it comes from a novel of the same name. I think it was from 76. But yeah, it's the first of the Anne Rice vampire novels. Now, if you know Anne Rice, you'll know that in recent years she basically kind of went a little crazy and like has disavowed all her old work and basically says like she doesn't want anything to do with it because I think she became like hyper-religious, and the vampire books, like the various characters sort of like explore their thoughts about like good and evil and eternity and heaven and hell and so on. And I guess she got to a point in her life where she felt like, you know what, that's all sort of blasphemous what I've written and whatever, which is crazy because they're really good books and they have a lot of like, you know, history and sort of culture and like artistic aesthetic and so on. There's a lot of like scene setting is, I guess, what I'm saying. But yeah, they're fascinating books in that they're, you know, they explore in great emotional and psychological depth the idea of like, okay, so if you were a vampire and you really did live forever, what would that entail? Well, it would entail everyone you know around you dying and societies like falling, crumbling, new ones coming to be and whatever, and they all die. Like, you're the only constant, or, you know, other people like you. And, you know, different characters deal with it in different ways, and indeed, the original series of books, you know, the first one is Interview with the Vampire, that's Louis's story, Louis being in the film, Brad Pitt's character, but, you know, Louis is a very emotional and sort of, you know, like, psychologically guilt-ridden and so on, vampire, so he's you know, probably my favorite of the characters, but, a very interesting character study in that book. Then there's a book called The Vampire Lestat, which is the vampire played by Tom Cruise in the film, and he's a very sort of like forceful, strident, and kind of aggressive character. So that book is interesting for a different reason. And then there's The Vampire Armand, played by Antonio Banderas in the film, though fair to say the physical description of the character in the books is very different from Antonio Banderas and his physical appearance. So because he's basically said to be, he's basically like a very young teen boy in his appearance, and he has like light brown hair and so on, so he looks nothing like Antonio Banderas. But yeah, he's like a sort of like really like philosophical and sort of like considered a vampire, very old. But anyway, the point is, they're a series of books, they're all very interesting. And they have, again, like, because they have different main characters of very different personalities, the feel of the different books is very different. So yeah, the only one, as far as I know, that was made into like a major motion picture was Interview with the Vampire, as I said, 94. It had a lot of famous actors, you know, Tom Cruise, Brad Pitt, Antonio Banderas, also Christian Slater plays the interviewer, Kirsten Dunst. As I don't know, she was like 12 or 13, but she plays a vampire in the film, and, you know, a pivotal character in the narrative, and she gives a really good performance for, you know, playing a person who is frustrated at never being able to grow into an adult because she's been turned into a vampire. So it's a cool movie, and the score is excellent. So the score was composed by Elliot Goldenthal, who's composed a number of film scores. Just to list off a few, Alien 3, Pet Sematary, Demolition Man, which is a cool movie, I should say, Heat, many people will know that film, A Time to Kill, another good film, In Dreams, Frida, Across the Universe, The Souls of Night, or Our Souls at Night, so a number of scores, including score for Interview with the Vampire, which is nominated for an Academy Award. I didn't win, but still, not easy to get a nomination. So we're going to listen to the opening tune that you hear at the beginning of the movie, and it's called Libera Me, and it's a tune or a song that's based on a Catholic prayer, but it's been altered from what I understand. Like, the prayer as it exists is "Save me from eternal death." And the prayer as it's heard in this rendering is, "O Lord, save me from eternal life," which, again, like, if you have eternal life, is it a blessing or is it a curse? Well, the longer it goes on, maybe, the more it'll feel like a curse. So I do feel like, especially for the character Louis, who, again, Interview with the Vampire is fundamentally Louis's story, It fits perfectly because, you know, he feels like he has been condemned to eternal life, as ironic as that may sound. So let's get to it. This is Libera Me, from the soundtrack to Interview with the Vampire by Elliot Goldenthal, 1994. Forgot to mention at the outset is the opening of the film. It's a sort of like overhead, like aerial, like three quarters sort of angle, where you're coming in from the bay in San Francisco and you're sort of flying over the city, and it's, you know, it's at night and it's, you know, the Golden Gate Bridge is lit up, so like as it comes in it has this very like, you know, elegant sort of look, but it's sort of dark, and you know, there's a sense of foreboding with this tune, which again, it's a perfect setup for the film. So it's another one where I think it's an excellent piece of music independent of its provenance, but if you know where it comes from, it is very evocative, and it, you know, it becomes permanently linked to that opening shot of the movie, which it, like, it's, again, it's this long single shot where you're like flying in over San Francisco. So yeah, like I said, if you haven't seen the movie, I would check it out. If you haven't read the books, I would check them out. If you do like sort of, you know, dramatic, historical, brooding fiction, which it very much is all of those things. So yeah, let me know what you think of the piece. I'll admit, other than, what was it, Demolition Man, and there was one other, Alien 3, I think, yeah. Alien 3 and Demolition Man, I've seen both of those movies. Oh, and Heat, that's right. And A Time to Kill. So like, I can't think of the score of any one of those films really, like, off the top of my head. Maybe Demolition Man more than any other, and that was done 1 year before this. It wasn't nominated for anything, which is interesting. His, his score for the film, Michael Collins, was nominated for a number of things. But ultimately, yeah, I don't know as much of his work as, say, like, Goldsmith or some of the other, like, major film composers. But if you are familiar with his work, let me know if there's anything else out there worth checking out. Other than that, I will see you next time. Peace.